Hello everybody, I am your mentor Muhammad Tariq, and from now we will be beginning with other subjects of civil engineering. Firstly, I will start with the construction materials that we use, and slowly we will proceed to the concrete technology, the environmental engineering, the construction, building construction part. And as you must be knowing, we have already covered quite a lot part of the surveying. So hope you people understand each and everything. Well, before I begin, I would like to ask you people to kindly subscribe to my channel and give your views, especially when there are any mistakes, it should be pinpointed, and for which I shall be very thankful, and I will try to improve those parts. So let's start right away with the bricks part. That is one of the building materials that we use in construction, and it is one of the major parts of our construction. So as we know, the bricks, here we come with the bricks. They are of two types of molding that is done. One is made by hand, that is known as handmade molded bricks, and the other is machine made bricks. So these two types of bricks we will deal with, and we'll go to the minor parts also of the bricks which are available in the market, as well as their strength, their requirements, and what they ought to have. Then there are light bricks, then there are heavy bricks, and what is the difference and the usage, along with the compressive and tensile strength of the bricks. As you can see in the video, the kneaded mud or the mixed mud with water has been softened and being loaded on the trolley for further molding purposes. From here, what we do is we just carry on the mud which has been kneaded in a very proper way and softened to the required limit, and being carried out towards the mold where it will be made in the form of a brick. So here you can see that this mud which was softened has been placed, and two laborers, they are working, and just see how they are making the bricks. The mold they have is of the size of the brick. It has the frog in which the manufacturer's name is written. Now, as you can see in the video once again, and you will find the procedure of wire cutting. So here you can see the procedure of wire cutting. I'll just repeat it and show you once again, and it just takes a fraction of a second, so be aware with it. So this is the procedure of wire cutting. This is done mainly on the machines where you cut the brick to a particular size of your specified size. Now we'll come back to our PPT again, and talking about the types of bricks that are available in the market, we have mainly four types of bricks that are available in the market, and the one is the ground molded bricks, as we have seen in the video just now, just back in the video. These are known as ground molded bricks because they are made on the ground. They are fired, or you can say heated, in temporary kilns. The kilns where they are heating, they are of a temporary type. So their shapes are normally irregular, and you must have seen in the way it was being made, it was not having a lot of precision in it, nor a lot of compaction was provided to it. So hence these sort of bricks, they are quite irregular in shape. Next is the table molded bricks. These are made on the table. If I'll be able to provide you with the video, I'll provide it in this one only ahead somewhere. So these are made on the table. It has a table platform where these bricks are made, and the fire or the heating is done in kiln. They are not temporary, they are permanent sort of kilns. Kilns meaning big ovens within which you provide heat. Firing and in the heating of bricks means that only you don't burn them, you only heat them. So that should be clear in your mind. Similarly, we have the machine molded bricks, and these machine molded bricks are also heated in continuous kilns. These kilns, they are of continuous types, and they are also cut with the help of a wire, as we have seen in the previous video just before, few minutes back. And finally, we have the best of the bricks, which are used for ornamental works. They are expensive and they are made under pressure, and because of this pressure, what we have is that the edges are very clear, they are very decorative, they have an architectural value as well. So these are the four types of bricks that are available in the market. Now next we'll come to the dimensions of the bricks. Now we come to the dimensions of the brick. Now the dimensions of the brick are of two types. That is, there are two sizes which are majorly used. In India, we have traditional size. Now this traditional size of a brick is 23 into 11.4 into 7.6 centimeter in size. And we have the other, that is the standard brick, and the size of the standard brick is 190 into 90 into 90 mm. So you must remember that over here we have talked in centimeters, and here we are talking in mm, so it can be easily converted. So I think there is no problem in it, right? Then we have the nominal brick. This nominal size of the brick is in mm, and the size is about 230 mm into 115 mm into 75 mm. So these are the three types of bricks that we are using, one being the traditional one, the other being the standard size brick, and the third one being the nominal size brick. So these bricks, they are also marketed in the market in size of 9 inches into 4.5 inch into 3 inch. So that is for the traditional banks. And for the metric sizes, we go with the nominal break and the standard breaks. Now, the important factor that we need to know, which I have discussed not in detail yet, so I'll be discussing it, and that is the word that is frog. Now, frog is a depression on top of the break. It is a depression. It is a depression right on the top of the break. I will show you in the next figure, and this contains the name of the manufacturer. The other purpose of the frog is to provide proper motor. Now, what is a motor? The motor means nothing else but the mix or the size or the ratio of the material, that is the coarse sand, the fine sand, and the cement that we are using in between two bricks to create a bond. The most important thing along with the mortar, the frog is always supposed to be placed in an upward direction. It should be placed in an upward direction. So the frog should be facing upwards in simple language. Whenever we are building a wall, in case of wall construction. So here we have the traditional brick size. This is about 4.5 inches in breadth, 9 inches in length, and 3 inches in height. So this is nothing else but a traditional brick that we are using, and this is a very common brick that you get everywhere around the cities of UP. It could differ in different states, and this is the normal size that we are using. So finally, we have the name of the manufacturer, which is embossed right on top of the brick. That is the frog over here. So as you can see, the name of the thing, the manufacturer, is embossed on the brick. I have highlighted it white so that it is crystal clear over there. The color will of course be absolutely the same. Now there are two other terms that I have used over here. That is, one is header and the other is stretcher. So what does this stretcher and this header mean? Now when we say header, that it means that the brick is being laid according to its breadth. It is laid according to its breadth. And when it is a stretcher, then the brick is laid according to its length. So this is the only difference between the two. So in one it is on the breadth and the other is on the length. So keeping of course the frog on top, which you always do in case of a construction purpose of a wall. Now we'll go through the some of the good qualities of a brick in very brief. So the edges of the brick should be sharp and clear so that the material that you use is less. If they are unsharp, you need to put in a lot of more mortar inside it. And the color should be uniform and it should be red. Then on banging two bricks, it should give out a metallic sound. So on banging two bricks, it should give a metallic sound. Then the weight of the brick should vary from 3 to 3.5 kg only. It should not be less than 3 kg and not more than 3.5 kg. Then we have the compressive strength of the brick. Now the compressive strength of the brick over here, as I've already mentioned, should not be less than 102 kg for a first class brick. The water absorption of the brick should not be greater than 20%. If it is more than 20%, means that it is acquiring or absorbing more water, meaning that there are more pores in it or there are more cavities in the brick. So the density of the brick will be down in that case. So these are some of the few standards which I have discussed with you. And later on, we'll go to some of the very detailed things in bricks only itself first. Then later on, we'll get on to cement and then the various tests of cement. If you want to watch the videos that I have made, on brickwork, that is the compressive strength, water absorption test and the crushing value, you can find the videos on this channel itself. So this is the name of my channel, Engineers India Solution. You'll be getting many other things which are related to your syllabus itself. And thanks a lot for watching. Thank you very, very much.